Hare Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandhu Jagat Pate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namo Tapto Kanchan Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishobhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Premo Prodayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Gauratishe Namo Harir Namo Harir Namo Harir Namo Iva Kevalam Kalo Nasteva 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 Gatiranatha Bhaja Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha Govinda Radha Govinda Radhe Jaya Radha Govinda Radha Govinda Radhe Jaya Radha Madan Mohan Radha Madan Mohan Radhe Radha Madan Mohan Jaya Radha Madhav Radha Madhav Radhe Jaya Radha বল প্রভু পাদের প্রাণ ধন হে জয় রাধা মাধব রাধা মাধব রাধে হরে কৃষ্ণ Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. বল গোবিন্দ জয় জয় গোপাল জয় জয় বল গোবিন্দ জয় জয় গোপাল জয় জয় রাধা রমণ হরি গোবিন্দ জয় জয় বল গোবিন্দ জয় জয় গোপাল জয় জয় গোবিন্দ জয় জয় রাধা রমণ হরি গোবিন্দ জয় জয় বল রাধা রমণ হরি গোবিন্দ জয় জয় বল গোবিন্দ জয় জয় গোপাল জয় জয় গোবিন্দ জয় জয় গোপাল জয় জয় রাধা রমণ হরি গোবিন্দ জয় জয় Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama Nitai Gaur Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo বলো নিতাই গৌরাঙ্গ, নিতাই গৌরাঙ্গ, নিতাই গৌরাঙ্গ, নিতাই গৌরাঙ্গ, নিতাই গৌরাঙ্গ, জয় গৌর হরি, বলো জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, জয় গৌর হরি, বলো জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, সচি মাতার প্রাণধন গৌর হরি, বলো জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, জয় নদিয়া বিহারে গৌর হরি, বলো জয় সচিনন্দন গৌর হরি, জয় সচিনন্দন আর গৌর হরি, জয় নদিয়া বিহারি, বলো সচি মাতার প্রাণধন গৌর হরি, সচি মাতার প্রাণধন গৌর হরি, গৌর হরি, জয় নদিয়া বিহারি, হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে হরে, হরে রাম হরে রাম 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 হরে হরে, হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ কৃষ্ণ হরে রাম Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, জয় জয় প্রভুপাদ 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 প্রভুপাদ, জয় জয় প্রভুপাদ প্রভুপাদ, জয় জয় প্রভুপাদ 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 প্রভুপাদ, জয় জয় প্রভুপাদ
Krishna, here we go. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki, Sri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Rani ki, Sri Jagannath Dev Ratha Yatra Mahamotsav ki, Bolo Srila Prabhupada ki, Iskan Society ki, Harinam Mahamantra ki, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming tonight, even in the rain. So we'd like to, without any further ado, we'd like to request His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj to come and say a few words to the congregation. Maharaj. Haribo, Haribo!
Yeah, come on. Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Sharashate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunnavadi Paschatta Dishutarine Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Shadigor Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama Hare Krishna. I feel very happy to have this opportunity to come and attend the Ratha Yatra festival yesterday and to attend this festival, this program today. I presume all of you took part in the Ratha Yatra yesterday. How many of you there for the Ratha Yatra festival? I thought as well, naturally. It's such a wonderful festival, and Srila Prabhupada told us that Krishna consciousness means festivals. We should have festivals every day. Actually, in spiritual world, they have festival continuously. Everything there is a Mahotsav, Maha Mahotsav. And when these festivals are there, then we forget all difficulties, all differences, and we simply become absorbed in a very joyful state of consciousness. And I was thinking yesterday that this is how we should actually spend our time. Wherever we go, that is how we should spend our time. When we are in New York, this is how we should spend our time. We must remember one thing, that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. How many of you accept that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of God? And when the Supreme Personality of Godhead says something, does it happen? Yes. How many of you believe that the words of the Supreme Personality of Godhead never goes in vain? How many of you are aware that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made a prediction that this Krishna consciousness movement would spread all over the world in every town and village? So, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that this Krishna consciousness movement would spread all over the world in every town and village, it's bound to happen. Well, let me ask you once again. How many of you believe that it is going to happen? Yes. it will happen. Krishna consciousness movement would spread all over the world in every town and village. When he says every town and village in this world, prithibite ache joto nagoradi gram, doesn't he indicate every town and village? Joto nagor adi gram. Every town and village, prithibite, all over this planet. Sarvatra prachar hoibe mon nam. This Harinam Sankirtan movement would spread in every town and village. Actually, today we should not have any doubt about the possibility of that becoming a reality. Had it been about 60 years back, maybe we could have had some doubt. But in last 50 years or so, we have seen what has happened in this world. Srila Prabhupada, at the age of 70, came to America, in this very city of New York. A 70-year-old person, literally penniless. He did not even have a single cent in his pocket. He did not know a single person in this city. And he arrived here. And he started his mission in total uncertainty, simply counting on the instruction of his spiritual master and complete faith in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prediction. He came to America and started this movement. And then we saw what happened within 10 years' time. Yesterday, I was looking at the New York skyline. I was seeing all these towering skyscrapers. And I was just considering that Srila Prabhupada came here penniless. And in 10 years' time, Srila Prabhupada owned one of the skyscrapers. What an achievement. And not only the skyscraper in New York, although it was Srila Prabhupada's pride, but it was just one of Srila Prabhupada's achievements. Srila Prabhupada spread the movement all over the world, at least in all the major cities of the world. And so what Srila Prabhupada did? Prabhupada himself used to say that people speak about miracle, people want to see miracles, and this is the greatest miracle, that Krishna consciousness movement spread all over the world. God consciousness, genuine God consciousness spread all over the world. People all over the world accepted Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead and dedicated their lives in that mission of his. Yes, I've done it. Thank you, Maharaj. So, Srila Prabhupada, that is what Srila Prabhupada achieved. And it is the greatest achievement. I mean, I at least don't recognize any achievement in the history that can compare this achievement of Srila Prabhupada. We read in the book of history the achievement of Alexander the Great and so forth, Napoleon and so forth. But compared to Srila Prabhupada's achievement, they become totally insignificant. Srila Prabhupada literally conquered the whole world with his mission. They tried to conquer the world with the military power. Srila Prabhupada conquered the world with his spiritual strategy. And not only that, we are seeing with the passing of time that this Krishna consciousness movement of Srila Prabhupada is expanding. Even as after Srila Prabhupada's disappearance, the movement is expanding. Like, we notice that generally after the disappearance of the founder of a spiritual movement, most of the time the movement crumbles. We have seen in the recent past, so many spiritual leaders came and created a wave, quite a sensational wave they created. But what happened? Soon after their disappearance, everything just disintegrated. Whereas in ISKCON we are seeing that in spite of Srila Prabhupada's disappearance from the planet, the movement is expanding. For example, when Srila Prabhupada was here, the number of temples were 108. And today we have more than 600 temples all over the world. More than 650 Ratha Jatras are being organized all over the world in the major cities. So these are the And if we look at the history of ISKCON, then we can see that after Srila Prabhupada's disappearance, there had been a crisis. Prabhupada himself said that when a spiritual leader leaves the planet, there is bound to be crisis. When an acharya, Prabhupada used the word acharya, when an acharya leaves the planet, there is bound to be crisis. And to tell you frankly, at that time, when I heard that, I felt that that may have happened in the past, that would not happen with us in ISKCON. But we saw after Srila Prabhupada's disappearance, so many problems, one after another, have been affecting our movement. It came to so many times, it came to a situation when we felt that it is a hopeless situation and everything is going to fall apart now. But we had been able to overcome those difficulties, obviously by Srila Prabhupada's mercy. And one thing also we have to recognize here, that Srila Prabhupada knew the difficulties we would face in the future, especially after his disappearance. Therefore, Prabhupada emphatically told us to collectively, jointly push this movement forward. Prabhupada emphatically told us that our love for him will be shown by how we cooperate with each other. So that is the secret. Our success is in our cooperation with each other to push the movement forward. And Prabhupada himself also pointed out, don't make the same mistake that my godbrothers made after Guru Maharaj's disappearance. What was the mistake? Guru Maharaj wanted them to collectively continue the mission. But they didn't want to do that. Instead of collectively pushing the movement forward, they started to fight with each other. And as a result of that, the institution or the massive movement that he started and the wonderful achievement that he had just disintegrated. Why? Because they failed to cooperate. Because they all wanted to become the acharyas. They became acharyas. An important thing to note, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur gave sannyas to 27 devotees. Not a single one fell down. They all carried on preaching. They all continued to preach, make disciples, and organize temples and... But the wonderful mission that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur started stopped. On the other hand, we can see that due to adhering to Srila Prabhupada's instruction, his mission is continued to expand because his followers are cooperating with each other. They are trying to collectively push this movement forward. And that is the secret of success of ISKCON today. We are having difficulties. We have our internal conflicts, but the general mood of the devotees is to cooperate and push the movement forward. And that is a very, very wonderful indication that this movement is here to stay, this movement is here to continue to spread Krishna consciousness to the point of spreading it all over the world in every town and village. Like, what did Srila Prabhupada want? Srila Prabhupada actually didn't want to start something on his own to become something himself. Prabhupada simply wanted all along to follow his spiritual master. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's vision was actually fixed towards the West. During his time, he sent some of his capable disciples to go to the West and start to preach. And this way we can see that although he established the movement so wonderfully all over India, but he wanted this movement to be taken out of India to the West and spread it all over the world. And Srila Prabhupada actually carried that vision, and Srila Prabhupada gave the shape to that mission. In that respect, I would say that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's Gauriya Math has been revived in the form of ISKCON. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's movement is actually ISKCON. ISKCON is not separate from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's mission. ISKCON is the manifestation, or I would say Srila Prabhupada revived Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's mission from the ruins of Gauriya Math. And that is ISKCON. So this is how we can see, it's a continuity. It's actually a continuity that is happening. Bhaktivinoda Thakur came and revived Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission also disintegrated practically soon after his disappearance, meaning about 250 years after his disappearance. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission and his dham and his teachings became completely covered by all kinds of upper sampradayas, deviated presentation in the name of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then came Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur from the ruins of what was created by the upper sampradayas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually revived the pure teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He did two things, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the dham of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anyway, I don't want to go into the details of that, but the point is, Bhaktivinoda Thakur came to revive Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. He gave it the shape. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur spread it all over India. And then Srila Prabhupada brought it out of India to the West. And the mission is continuing by his divine arrangement of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. Prabhupada knew that an institution is essential to continue the mission. If the institution was not there, then the mission would have disintegrated after his disappearance. In order to continue the mission, Srila Prabhupada was so emphatic about creating that institution. And the secret of success of the institution is recognizing Srila Prabhupada as the head of the institution for all time. Srila Prabhupada is not only the founder of ISKCON, Srila Prabhupada is the Acharya of ISKCON. And Srila Prabhupada will continue to remain the Acharya of ISKCON for all time. And I can admit that we have established that quite successfully by establishing, not only identifying Srila Prabhupada as the founder Acharya, but through the practice like Srila Prabhupada's Guru Puja being conducted in every temple every day. In every temple every day, Srila Prabhupada's Guru Puja will be conducted as long as ISKCON will be there. That indicates who is the Guru of ISKCON. Who is the Guru of ISKCON? Srila Prabhupada. It is not that other Gurus won't be there, but they all will function under the authority of Srila Prabhupada. That is the meaning of the title, Prabhupada. Prabhupada at the lotus feet, at whose lotus feet other Prabhus will sit. So all the Gurus of ISKCON will sit at Srila Prabhupada and function as his representatives. And that is what is going to hold our institution together. Anyway, there's a lot of things to say. I hope I'm not taking too much time. And I will end with a very, very humble and simple request that have implicit faith that this movement will spread all over the world in every town and village. It will happen. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's words are not going to go in vain. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could have done that in a flash of a moment. He could make the whole world Krishna conscious. But he didn't do that because the Lord's one unique quality is that he wants to glorify his devotees. And we are seeing how he glorified Srila Prabhupada through this achievement. In a way, we can see that Srila Prabhupada's achievement is even greater than Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's achievement. And that is what Sri Krishna does. Krishna gave the credit of winning the battle of Kurukshetra to Arjuna, and in order to give the total credit to him, he decided that he's not going to touch any weapon. Because if he took a weapon and fought the battle, then everyone would have said that, well, Krishna actually fought, that's why they won the battle. But because he wanted to give the absolute credit of winning the battle of Kurukshetra to Arjuna, he said, he took a vow, I'm not going to fight this battle. So similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left this wonderful recognition and credit, reserved it for Srila Prabhupada, to glorify his very, very special devotee. And Srila Prabhupada also could have spread this movement all over the world. I mean, the way the movement spread within 10 years' time, we can well imagine if Srila Prabhupada stayed for another 10 years, then we don't know what could have happened to this world. But Prabhupada decided to leave the planet. Krishna wanted Prabhupada to come back to him. Why? Because Srila Prabhupada wanted us to do something for this movement, to get some credit, some recognition, some achievement ourselves, so that we can at least have some satisfaction that I have contributed something to this mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So let us recognize that this movement is going to spread all over the world in every town and village, and now Krishna is giving us some opportunity to become a part of this movement. And if we become a part of this movement, our life will become successful. So let's all forget all the differences, all the problems that is there. They will come and go. That's not very important. But let's recognize the important thing is that we are getting an opportunity to be a part of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's glorious Sankirtan movement. And let's take full advantage of that. Thank you all very much.
Charu Maharaj ki. We'd like to offer to Maharaj beautiful as kind of teacher. There you go. And we'd like to invite His Holiness Radhanatha Maharaj to come and say a few words. Thank you, Maharaj.
Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Hastachate Satarine Vanshakalpatarubhyascha Kripasindhubhya evacha Patithanam bhavanibhyo Vaishnavebhyo namo namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasati Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna. I am very grateful to be with you. Srila Prabhupada, as a small child, organized Ratha Yatra celebrations in the back alleyways of Calcutta. He came to New York City knowing no one,
with nothing. In one lecture, he said that he was practically loitering, homeless, without a friend. He appealed to people in India to help, but no one had confidence that he could succeed. So there was no help. And 11 years later, he was riding on Subhadra Devi's chariot. Thousands of people, hundreds and hundreds of devotees on a Ratha Yatra parade down Fifth Avenue. When Srila Prabhupada was first here in 1965, he was thinking, and he said it later, that New York is the most important city in the world and Fifth Avenue is the most important street in the world. And the street was closed down for all traffic so that Lord Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra could travel to the Vrindavan of Washington Square Park. And it is still happening today, every year. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would invite his devotees every year to Jagannath Puri to celebrate Ratha Yatra together. It was a time of a great reunion among the Vaishnavas. Devotees from Orissa, from all different parts of Bengal. There are many beautiful, sweet descriptions of the interactions between Lord Chaitanya and the various devotees, and the devotees among themselves. As they came from all directions, with great efforts, Shivananda Sen would organize walking for 300-400 devotees from the villages of Bengal to Sri Jagannath Puri. When they would arrive at the Atharanala bridge, one year, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was waiting to offer with his own loving hands a garland to each and every devotee. He would cover their bodies with his own hand and flower with sandalwood pulp and embrace them. And he would bring them to Gambira, where his residence was, and have personal interactions, greeting each one, praising their glories. And then he would arrange accommodations, prasad, assistance, and everything for the devotees' comforts. And the first year when the devotees came and Lord Chaitanya was greeting them all, he was speaking sometimes with five mouths the glories of each devotee. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami tells that the highest, most intimate truth is how the Supreme Personality of Godhead loves and appreciates his devotees. But one devotee was not there. Lord Chaitanya asked, where is Haridas? Everyone looked around. They couldn't see Haridas. He came all the way from Bengal, but he wasn't there in Lord Chaitanya's quarters. Then Haridas was seen in a distant place, laying on the side of the dirt road in full prostration. Lord Chaitanya said, bring him. When they approached Haridas, still laying down in the dust, he said, I am not fit to be with the devotees in such a holy place as the Gambira. So Lord Chaitanya came all the way to where Haridas was. He lifted Haridas and embraced him. Then Lord Chaitanya went hand in hand with Haridas to a very simple garden, a place where he could see the chakra of Jagannath's temple. Because Lord Chaitanya knew that Haridas did not feel himself fit to enter into the temple. There were social conventions, but it was also Haridas's own humility. He would not go against those social conventions. And Srila Prabhupada would love to tell the story how every day in the early morning, Lord Chaitanya would go in for the darshan of Lord Jagannath. And in the form of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Jagannath would come outside the temple every day to visit Haridas Thakur. Jagannath would come off the altar in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to bring Haridas Mahaprasad every day. And they would sit together and chant the holy names and discuss Krishna for several hours. When Sanatana Goswami came to Puri, he stayed with Haridas Thakur. When Rupa Goswami came to Puri, he stayed with Haridas Thakur. None of them would go in the temple. But Lord Chaitanya would come out to be with them, to embrace them, to have Hari Katan, Hari Kirtan with them, to bless them. One day, Lord Chaitanya, he brought a toothbrush of Lord Jagannath Mahaprasad. Because he saw Haridas Thakur was doing his 300 names of Krishna, sometimes under the summer sun of Puri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pushed that toothbrush in the ground and immediately a bakula tree grew. And within minutes, it was a full tree to give Haridas Thakur very pleasing shade. Because Haridas Thakur Kirtaniya Sadahari, he was constantly chanting the holy names. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu considered Haridas to be the crown jewel of the entire creation. When Haridas left this world, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he danced with his body, he bathed his body, he buried his body, and then he went out into the town to beg for prasad to celebrate the festival of Haridas Thakur's life and disappearance. And at that time during the feast, Lord Chaitanya proclaimed that Haridas Thakur, who is Brahma himself, he appeared as the Acharya of the chanting of the holy names. And he established the chanting of the holy names throughout the world. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he tells, this is the love between the Lord and such a devotee. We have just heard from His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj how Srila Prabhupada, he spread the chanting of the holy names of Krishna throughout the entire world. There's Ratha-Yatra ceremonies in almost every major city on the planet. Hundreds of temples. Kirtaniya Sadahari. Srila Prabhupada's simple message to us to always chant the names of Krishna. Yesterday we saw thousands of people chanting the names of Krishna. In London there are hundreds and thousands who chant the names of Krishna and Radha. In Delhi there's hundreds and thousands of people. In Calcutta, hundreds and thousands. Our dear Srila Prabhupada to Lord Chaitanya. With hundreds of mouths, thousands of mouths, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is appreciating, glorifying the love of Srila Prabhupada's greatness. Because, as Maharaj has told us, more than anyone else in the history of this world, to all classes of people, from all nationalities, from all religions, from all social backgrounds, he has induced to chant Krishna's holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. When Srila Prabhupada was here in New York City in 1966, I believe, before even 22nd Avenue, he had a program at somebody's little flat, and he played a little tape recording of himself chanting. And he writes in his diary, there was just like 5 or 6 people that came to the event. And Prabhupada said, they liked the chanting. Now I understand that the desire of Haridas Thakur, that the holy name will spread throughout the world, will be fulfilled. New York is the birthplace of ISKCON. Throughout Srila Prabhupada's pastimes of spreading Krishna consciousness all over the world, he would refer to New York. We have such an opportunity together to fulfill Srila Prabhupada's dream, to spread Krishna consciousness in wonderful, magnanimous way throughout this great city of New York. This is Srila Prabhupada's blessing upon us that we have that chance. Thank you very much.
Bhakti Chu Maharaj, and all our senior god brothers for coming today. Please acknowledge by saying, Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Of course, we have a wonderful feast prepared. by the grace of very surrendered devotees, same devotees who were working yesterday so hard to prepare nice prasadam for all the guests who are coming, have prepared with the same love and devotion a feast for all of you tonight. We're very happy to be able to do this, but it's not possible without your assistance. We'd like to give you a loving exchange. We've printed very wonderful t-shirts in recognition of Srila Prabhupada's contribution. ISKCON New York City, established 1966. His Divine Grace, Founder Acharya's Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So please wear these t-shirts proudly. Give a donation, whatever you feel. We're just, like I said, this is just something to keep the momentum going. And because we have limited time when we have these facilities, we'd like to ask everyone to excuse our dignitaries that they may go down and take prasadam. You may also go down at this time. We'd like to do some kirtan first, because we've never had so many at one time that we can chant so nicely. So I think that Chaitanya Nanda, who will chant? Well, then you, who's got the, where's Radha-Krishna? Radha-Krishna, come play the madanga. Well, Chaitanya Prabhu can chant, certainly. We can get a few devotees to come and chant. Not it. Just be a short kirtan, 15 minutes.
Thank you. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasudeva
Hare Rama
Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nithai Gauranga, 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 Jaya Sachinandana, 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 Gora Hare. Nandana Gaura Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Vinda Hari Gopala Hari. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Jagora Haribo, 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 Nitagora Haribo.
So we'd like to just, of course, remind everyone, prasadam is being served upstairs. There's a couple of other small announcements. One is that there's Ratha Yatra in Connecticut. Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Ki. This is Nitya Ratha Yatra. Everywhere there's Ratha Yatra, somewhere. This universe or other universes. So Saturday, June 16th, 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. in Bushnell Park in Hartford, Connecticut. Okay. 12 p.m. to 6 p.m., June 16th, Bushnell Park, Hartford, Connecticut. Everyone is invited. And after prasadam, because there's extended darshan today at Sri Sri Radha-Govinda Mandir, we're encouraging everyone that if they like after prasad, they can go have darshan at Radha-Govinda Mandir. All right. Should I do anything else?